Welcome to our fourth and final lesson here about using document templates in InDesign. As always, it's brought to you by Printwand. So we've gotten a lot of good information in the previous three portions of our video, and we're going to end our lesson here by discussing document templates in InDesign and how we use them to put together our files and what's involved in them. So here we have a sample template of a folder that we're working on in InDesign. And we're going to want to go ahead, we'll head up to our menu bar, we'll go over to Edit, and then we'll go down to Select All. So if we look up, we can see here that we have the dimensions of our template set at slightly larger than 20 1/4 inches by about 16 1/4 inches. We'll go ahead and deselect our image by clicking off in the area outside of our document. First, now let's notice these tabs on the left and right hand sides of our template. These are what our pockets attach to. Now they both fold in, and then the pocket at the bottom of the document will fold up. It's glued to the tabs, and this is what creates our pocket. But for right now, we don't really need to worry about them at this point. Let's go ahead and we'll head up back up to our menu bar. We'll go to File, and then Document Setup. So we notice here what comes up is a document size of 18 1/2 inches by 16 1/4 inches. So notice this is narrower than the template that we previously looked at the dimensions of. But that's because of these tabs that we just talked about. So we'll go ahead and we'll hit OK. We'll exit out of our document setup view, and we're going to continue checking out our document. Okay, so let's go back up to our menu bar, and this time we'll head over to Windows, and we'll head down to Layers. So if we look at our Layers palette, we can see that we have our document template as well as our document artwork both on separate layers, and this is exactly what you want. This is accomplished by going down to the bottom of the Layers panel and clicking here on Add a New Layer. So in order to work in different layers, all you have to do is click over the layer name, and that places you in that layer. So if you look just left of the layer name, you're going to notice two boxes. One contains this little eye icon, and this is what toggles the layer on and off. The other box contains a lock, and this is when you can lock the layer, and you can toggle that on and off too. And it enables you to lock the layers so that you can't mistakenly move something around that you don't want to. So let's just go ahead and make our art layer visible, and we can see how our layout works in relation to our template. Now notice here that a portion of our artwork is extending past our template lines. This is called our bleed area, and this is an area that extends out at least 1/8 inch past our document size. Okay, so let's go ahead and head back up to our menu bar, and we're going to go to View, move down to Grids and Guides, and then over to Show Guides. And now we can see this red line here, and this is what represents our document bleed area. And our artwork correctly extends out into this area. Everything lines up the way we need it to. But now, with our guides on, we can also see these purple lines on the inside of our template. Now, these represent our artwork live area, and they're located 1/4 inch inside of our document area. And this is the area that we want our art and copy to stay in so that it doesn't get cut off at the margins. We'll head back over to our layers palette, and then we're going to toggle on our live area layer. Now, we don't have to have a live area layer in our final document. I'm kind of just showing this to you for the purpose of seeing how things relate to each other, and so it's a little more clear for you to see. And we can see that everything is lined up and laid out correctly in our document. Everything falls within our document template and the lines that are established here with our guides. So if we notice here these groups or markings at the bottom of the template, now these are indicators for different groupings of business card slits. There's a number of different orientations that we can use, but what we want to keep in mind with this is that after we've selected the area that we want to use for our business cards, it's important not to place text in that specific area. Otherwise, it's going to be covered up by the card, and we're not going to be able to see anything that's behind the card itself. So here, we have some tips to keep in mind and look out for when we're using our document templates and making sure that our file is set up correctly in preparation for going to print in InDesign. Make sure to check back often to PrintWand for more video lessons, as well as other articles to help you with your marketing and promotional needs.